Hello, I'm Eric Kanaker, co-founder of Dibeloop. Dibeloop started in 2015. Guillaume Charpentier, diabetologist, had been working within his nonprofit, bringing together patients and doctors to try to get a first version of a closed loop working. And it came to me in 2015. And that came together with a company that today we're 85 people, and we're ready to launch our commercial release across Europe with reimbursement undergoing in France, in Germany. So what do we do? We do a closed loop for people living with type 1 diabetes. So we take a CGM, an insulin pump, both off the shelf with partners that we work with, and we have a handset, DBLG1, that links both of them together and makes a decision every 5 minutes autonomously. Complex algorithms because the system needs to be simple for the user, efficient, and also personalized, because every person has a different life, different lifestyle, different physiology, different preferences. The algorithms behind it, first of all, you have a safety layer. Is there a risk of hypoglycemia? What do we need to do there? Then you have the really complex part of machine learning, within a physiological framework that's going to look at the past, do the machine learning to forecast both insulin needs and glucose levels. But machine learning sometimes isn't perfect. So we have a supervisor, which is a patented technology, that is going to look, is machine learning reliable? And if not, hand it over to an expert system that is mimicking what a diabetologist or an expert patient would be doing. Then you have a self-learning layer that's going to be looking at weeks worth of data to look at each patient's own rhythms, week versus weekend, breakfast versus dinner, night versus day. So does it work? Yes, it works great. We've got, in the pivotal clinical trial, time in range improvement of 14% in the randomized clinical trial. In real life, plus 18% versus the same patients before. Hypoglycemia divided by 3. Those numbers are great, but that's not really what matters. What really matters is the feedback from the users that tell us, you know, I can live my life much closer without having to think about diabetes as much. I can eat like my kids. I can go on holiday things with spouses, kids, whatever. And that's what matters. Where are we going? First of all, we're going to have additional indications. Highly unstable diabetes, has been discussed separately. Children, 6 to 12 years old, clinical trial with outstanding feedback from both the parents and the doctors. Teens with specific needs regarding that specific category of age. From a functionality, the ability not having to declare meals. So for us, that's really fundamental that sometimes you don't have to declare a meal. You can if you want to really have results that are as great as possible. Sometimes your own priority is living a life. Hormonal effects, menstrual cycle, of course, but also stress and other hormones that we're going to include into the algorithm. And then evolution on short-term insulin sensitivity. From a product perspective, focus on user experience, iterate and keep iterating on that to make it as easy as possible to use and fit for everyone's life. Interoperability, and then additional devices, because again, some people really would want to have it on a smartwatch, or others want it on a bigger screen. Interoperability, what does that mean? That means, first of all, choice. So our system has linked up to 3 pumps, Cellnova pump, Dana I, and then the Kaleido pump. And we're in the process of integrating at least 2 more pumps. And so that will give people choice to wear one pump versus another because that's what they want, or in certain countries because they don't have a choice because the reimbursement setup system is set up that way. Unannounced meals. Rather than making big discourses, there's one person. She has an extremely demanding job. She's got 3 kids. And this is real life data that I'm showing you, not on a clinical trial. Her focus is really spending as little time on diabetes as possible and focusing on her job that she's passionate about and on her children. So the first line shows a day that's a decent day, 57% time in range, no hypos, average glucose, that's okay, no time spent announcing meals or calculating, that's actually a quite decent day. Surprisingly, that's actually really far from being the best day that the DBLG1 system can achieve for unannounced meals. In this particular case, this person had two meals, 80% time in range, 148 milligrams average glucose level, no hypos. And that's really what it's all about. She can spend her time on her priorities as she wants to. Thank you very much.